Hey, what's up guys, this is Iborn Stellar bringing you another game on Caspian Border, playing some Conquest, I think with 64 or 63 other people, I think. So, and I think somebody asked me for just a straight up, you know, me talking about the gameplay instead of talking about the news story, so I thought, alright, I can do that, you know, I can make a commentary just for the gameplay and I'll have another one just for the news stories right after this one, as well as two other live commentaries that I recorded earlier. So, four commentaries just for Battlefield 3. So, yeah, quite a bit of stuff for you guys today to watch. So, I hope you enjoy all the videos that I made for you guys today. So, and I guess let's get down to me talking about the gameplay. So, right now I'm in a jet flying around. I think it's the flanker jet. And I don't even know how I sometimes can forget the names. I mean, there's only two jets in the game, the Flanker and the Super Hornet. So yeah, sorry that I forget the names sometimes. So, and I got behind this guy, hopefully I can kill him, but I think he ends up in the ground right there. I think he jumped out before it exploded, but still, what the hell, why would you go down there anyway? But rock pods, they are such an amazing thing to use. I mean, right here, I don't even know what the hell I was thinking. I was like, I'm going in. Yep, nope, I'm not going in. I'm going into the junkyard or something. Because I just got destroyed by the pole. So, those damn poles. I don't know how they stay, you know, where they are without them going flying everywhere. Because a jet just, you know, crash into them. I mean, what the fuck? Shouldn't Frostbite 2 be able to, I don't know, make poles that are destructible? So, I don't know, it's weird. And right there, I don't even know what the hell I was getting shot at by. I think it was one of their helicopters. And I guess right away, I'm using the M98B with the ballistic 12x zoom scope. I think with the laser sight, and I believe the straight pull bolt, so makes it so you don't have to zoom out to you know, get another shot bolt action sniper rifles like the M98B or, you know, the SV98 or N48.5. So a must have, I think, for any bolt action user out there. So right here, I think we pretty much locked down the whole area early on, so excuse me, getting a bit of water here because my throat's getting a little dry, so gotta keep it nice and you know, nice and wet in there, I guess you could say, you know, or what's the word that I'm looking for, hydrated, I think. So yeah, can't have enough water in your you know, system, so, because I still need my throat to be ready to go after this commentary is over, because I still need to do the BF3 daily news, so, and there's tons to talk about, so, but thankfully, the next commentary is gonna be awesome, I think it is, because it's me flying in Operation Firestorm with the jets, the Super Hornet, I think, and, you know, for 22 minutes, I'm just flying around pretty much on a pose. I mean, there's a few times where I almost get destroyed, but I do some badass shit that, you know, hopefully you'll see in the actual video of me being awesome with the jets and, you know, using the repair tool in a cool way. So I guess that's as much as I can tease you guys to watch the video, so go check it out right after this one. So, but anyway, I'm still doing work with the M98B here. I thought, oh, why not shoot at that guy over there? And of course, I hit nothing. And I think I actually killed a gunner once with the, I believe it was with the M48.5 that I killed a guy with the M48.5. He was the gunner of the helicopter. And I think it was in Carg Island. It was just so funny when it happened. Like, I was not expecting to hit the guy because I thought that the windshield was bulletproof, but turns out it's not, so a bullet from the sniper rifle would definitely penetrate those windshields. So I don't know, I thought that the windshields would be bulletproof, but they're not, so oh well, you can shoot them if you can get lucky, I guess. So, but right here, like I said, we pretty much locked down all of the flags pretty much early on, so throughout here, I think it's pretty much us just, I don't want to say base ripping. That was pretty funny how that guy just went up in the air. But more or less base ripping, because we don't let them get out of their spawns, so we're pretty much just camping them, you know, until the game ends. So that's pretty much what I did anyway. So I think some guys were still back there going like, where the hell is everybody? And me going like, they're at their base, idiots. So, but, and I think here I get the, my final ribbon for, sniping, so I still needed like a few more to get the medal for sniping. So, you know, for getting 7 kills with a sniper rifle, that would get you a ribbon. And I think I have 48 of them, but now I have 50, I think. So, finally get the medal, so pretty awesome. I get the dog tag too. I think it's called Peekaboo, fuck you, or something. So, yeah, dice and their humor. I mean, all of the dog tags are pretty funny in some ways, so. And of course, I gotta move up a little bit because there's nobody around. So go next to these trees, trying to find a few a good cover spot, because there's probably gonna be a few snipers, you know, looking our way. So, and I think I see a guy up in that rock, but I think I miss him. Shoot at this guy, don't quite get him, but I get a suppression and kill assist. So, this guy up there, but he moves at the very last second. That was a miss. That was when he moved. And they get another suppression kill assist, so bit of a bummer they didn't get him, but I think I get a few more kills after that fail there, I guess. So, and of course, there's a lot of tanks everywhere, so I gotta stay clear of the roads, because the sniper is not gonna do anything against tanks, so better to stay clear of any incoming tanks. So. Ugh. Sorry about the yawn. Bit sleepy here. But, anyway, I guess real quick. Today, December 4th, I put the Christmas tree up, so yay for that. Don't have to worry about putting that thing up anymore. It took me like 2 hours. I mean, there's so many lights, and putting the tree together and putting the lights outside. Such a pain, but, you know, it's over with, so. Thank God for that, but I guess that's that as far as my update on what's going on in my life right now. And I get a pretty good headshot on that guy, 273 meters away, pretty good headshot, and I get, I think that was the second star for the M98B, I think I already got 100 kills with it, so that was 200 kills with it, so, and I get the PKA holosight, so probably never gonna use it, because I'm not a big fan of the PKA holosight, so. Well, at least for snipers, I'm not, so better use a ballistic or a ACOG, in my opinion. Those are the best ones. Put a few shots on that guy. I think I put a shot on him, but then somebody kills him. Or I kill him. Never mind. I get a kill on him. Now that I headshot, so. Of course, comes another jet over the hill, and see this guy over there. I'm like, yo, man, boom, headshot. 141 meters, not bad. But, still looking for more targets. I think a helicopter's incoming. Oh, damn, sorry. But, oh yeah, there's the helicopter. They took over A. And this guy's going in, about to blow up. But I thought I could get a headshot on one of those guys in the helicopter, but not quite. See the guy right there, but he goes behind cover, so I can't get a good shot on him, so. Line of sight is obstructed, so gotta go in there and look for him, and I think somebody else kills him, so yeah, spot bonus, there you go. Someone got him. Of course, my teammates are getting A back, so I'm like, I probably should head back to the where I was, you know, to the spot where I was camping a few minutes ago, so, because we got A back, so. That's the third yawn in 5 minutes, wow. And I tried to get a headshot on that one guy, but I couldn't quite do it. There's a tank out to the right, just hanging out, trying to get a few kills. I was thinking about putting down the map drone out there to get a few more, what's it called, you know, a few more points just for spotting people, but couldn't quite do it, so. And see that guy over there, I put a shot on him and failed to get a headshot. fell again. And finally get a kill on him, so sniper rifle ribbon for the win. So got another one of those. I think that was a second. Oh, here we go. Here's the ribbon or the medal. Finally, I got the sniper rifle master dog tag, which has a peekaboo fuck you. So pretty cool that I got that. So I got a combat proficiency ribbon too. So 7 kills in a row without dying. Well, I think that's what it is. I mean, sometimes it's 3 kills, sometimes it's 7. I mean, what's up with that? So, or I think they changed it to 3. I don't even know what's up with that ribbon anymore. Because I have a lot of them, and I don't think I've had that many 7 kill streaks, or, you know, 7 kills in a row without dying, so. But, getting close to the end here. Seeing a lot of tanks, not a whole lot of infantry units, so I'm like, ah, crap, what do? I just stand around here by the tree, try not to get killed, 10-1, not too bad, given that I've been sniping the whole time, and I kind of failed the beginning with the jet, but, you know, it could have been worse, I guess, but, still looking for more targets, and I think I get another kill after this one. I'm not sure if I did. Get inside that bush, trying to get more cover, because you can never have enough cover. There comes another helicopter passing through, can't see me because I'm in a bush. Bushes for the win if you're sniping. And I'm not sure how he didn't see me, actually. I'm like pretty much in the open. So, flying around, I'm looking at him, I'm like, hell no, game's about to end. So it ends right about here when I failed to kill this guy. So I probably should have taken the shot and killed him anyway. So. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Of course, we won. It was a pretty short video, more or less. 12 minutes, not very long. But like I was saying, I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to comment on the video, rate and subscribe. And also look for the upcoming Battlefield 3 news, daily commentary, as well as the previous uploaded live commentaries that I made today. Pretty good ones, you know, so check them out if you like. And as always, you know, the MW3 daily commentary with news stories as well. So if you like MW3, check that video out as well. But I guess I will see you guys later. And as always, you know, don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. So later.